Kia ora guys, Jan Arts here for Juice TV, and today I'm chilling with Nathaniel. How are you?
Hey buddy, good mate, yourself?
I'm very good, thank you. Fantastic. Now this is your first time, I understand, here in New Zealand.
First time in NZ, and I'm loving it, having such a good day.
What have you got up to so far?
A whole bunch of interviews and promo. I went on a jet boat as well. That was pretty fun.
Whereabouts was that?
At the harbour, yeah. So it was good, a lot of fun.
Good. Hopefully we can get you back here in 2014 for like a little performance or something.
Yeah, I'd love to. Let's organise that. Let's do it.
Nice, let's do it. Let's make it happen. I need to focus on music though. Before the X Factor, you were an Australian Idol.
I was, yeah.
And you have said that you weren't quite ready as an artist back then. How have you benefited from X Factor Australia?
Oh, immensely. It's been the breakthrough for my career. It really opened a lot of doors for me. I learned so many tools to take off the show and go on my own way, and it's paying off, so it's good.
Nice. And I saw a little performance in front of Alicia Keys. She was quite impressed. When a man loves a woman, and you sang that with Guy Sebastian in New York at a bar, and she had her band in the background.
How
was that experience?
Yeah, so long story short, I sang the song for her, and then the day we found out that we were in the top 12, Guy took us out to Times Square, we had a bite to eat and stuff, he shared us dinner, and we went to this bar, and some of Alicia Keys' band members were on stage, and other guys that had just played with Michael Jackson, just a whole bunch of people, and Guy knew the band members, and he got up and sang a song with them, and he called me up to sing a song as well, and it happened.
Fuzzy. Does that faze you at all, or are you just quite confident in that
situation? I was freaking out, man. I'm in this new country, New York, and these incredible musicians behind me. I was freaking out, but I pulled myself together and I got there in the end.
Yeah, and hopefully a few more things like that.
Definitely.
And also you've been working closely with David and Anthony from DNA Songs. Yeah. They work with like a smorgasbord of different artists. What's it like to work with that duo?
Incredible. They've got a great chemistry to work with, and we've been writing some really great songs, some really, really good songs. So I'm excited. I can't wait to show them off.
Nice. And that wasn't even going to happen. How did that song come together?
Yeah, look, it was one of those songs that was blood, sweat and tears. It took a while to really immerse and crack out of its shell. During the day, we were coming up with a whole bunch of ideas and stuff, writing them, and nothing sort of stuck out and said, hey, this is the song we want to continue with. And later that night, after being frustrated all day, as we were walking out the door about to get a bite to eat, I just started singing the chorus of You. And I looked at them and go, hey, do you think that's cool? And they're like, yeah, come in, let's work on it and build a track around it and write some lyrics and stuff. And we pretty much forgot about the hunger issue. So we just stayed in the studio, finished the song off, and one thing led to the other, and now it was the first single. So.
And now you're on a nationwide tour of Australia with Jessica Mauboy.
Yeah.
How's that been so far?
Incredible. We just finished the leg in November, the first leg of the tour, on the road, and that was fun. And the next, we have the next leg in January, which is going to be on the road, a lot of long drives and stuff. So it's going to be a lot of fun. I can't wait.
Awesome. And are there any things that you can tell me that's going to go down in 2014? Anything we can look forward to besides your album? Anything else going down?
Well, with the single, I think I may be up for an APRA award and an ARIA nomination. So fingers crossed, hopefully they show themselves to me. And we're just about to crack double platinum with the single as well, so just trying to keep busy. Obviously we've got the tour in Jan and the second single, and then the whole promo run we'll do again and stuff. And you've got the idea. I would love to do my own headlining tour in about a year's time. So I guess we're just going to try and work towards that as well.
Work towards a little summer hotspots tour of New Zealand?
Yes, I would love to.
Some beaches for you?
Yeah. Look, I haven't had much time to spend here, unfortunately. I have to go home in a couple of hours, but when I come back, I definitely want to take the time out and have a look around and see what it's all about.
Awesome. Okay, that is it for me. It's a nice little interview with you, and I'm going to throw to your single, You, but I've chosen a different version. I've chosen the acoustic version,
which
is just as good, or maybe two times better.
Yeah, great. Fantastic. Right. Thank you.
Check it out.